And we are now going to start. The game is beginning. So Red Comet, if you've watched any of my casts at all, at any time, you have seen it. Because Red Comet is a map that everyone knows about. Wait, something's wrong. Oh, darn it. Okay, we have a slight technical error. It happens sometimes. Players are on the wrong teams. Okay, they're working it out. They're working it out. They know what to do. They're gonna at least... It's messed up, but they are going to keep everything normal. They're gonna keep everything sane. It's all been sorted. They're good. So Lauri is in the left side of the map, or west side of the map, and Klon is in the east side of the map. Klon goes for a very quick clickabout factory. It's southeast, which is a very unusual starting position on the east side of the map, while Lauri, on the other hand, fairly typical going for southwest, but yeah, it's northeast and center east. Those are the typical positions. This is all point plus 2.28, but yeah. This and this are typical positions. This is a bit of a defensive position. Well, Lauri, what they're in now is more defensive. This is a bit more up front, and this is just sneaky. It's a little bit tricky. You can't easily defend the stuff back here, but you kind of can, and the thing is, this is just sneaky, because I think what Klon is thinking is that Lauri's going to go down here. They're expecting Lauri to be down here and try to go for something a bit more late game focused, like Hovercraft. Something that focuses on having a lot of units, whereas with the Cloaky, they don't move as quickly, they can't easily get around the map, so from corner to corner it's not so easy, but when they're going from the same side of the map, like from southeast to southwest, that's really easy, and now Klon's kind of giving it away. Just with the one glaive, but at this point, Klon has a very short rush distance, and Lauri, on the other hand, if they just attack the north side, they attack from the north side, which is exactly what they're doing. Actually, they're attacking because I think they suspect that Klon is over to the north. But Lauri is going to have an easy way of getting in from there unless Klon sets up some defenses over to the north side of their base. But yeah, this is unusual. This never happens. You never see someone start Red Comet on the north, southeast or northwest. Bearing in mind, this is rotationally symmetric. Yeah, Lauri's figured out what's going on now. It's probably going to head south from here. We'll see if these daggers, are they going south? Yes, they are. The daggers are indeed going south. And... well, actually, it looks like... oops. No, they've seen the north side. They now know over that Klon is over to the south. But at this point, Klon's already kind of set up. However, Lauri is expanding a fair bit faster. Lauri has more energy. Klon, not so much. Klon is really trying to set up some defenses over to the north, but can't easily secure most of the map. They can kind of secure the south side, but they can't easily secure the rest of the eastern side of the map because they have to basically set up defenses. Their Cloaky bots are slower. This is a really risky strategy from Klon. And I think that the window has probably closed. Yeah, the window has closed for it. There are already 5 daggers compared to 5 glaives. Klon really probably should have been more aggressive, I think. When you are building like this, this is a really early rush game rush strategy. You're trying to attack from an unexpected position. You're trying to hit them before they're ready, and Lowry's gotten ready. Lauri has maces now, or, well, a mace is coming. It's going to be 30 seconds for that mace to come in, but yeah, once that comes in... that's basically game. Like, Klon doesn't really have much to do against that. Really no answer to that. Looks like Klon might... I don't know, they're continuing to go for glaives. No big change there. Klon's commander, however, not been morphed either. They are being very risky here. This defender is going to be useful, but then once the rest of the daggers come in, that's basically it. Now, from here, Klon, I mean, it's not totally hopeless. So there's plenty of time. There's plenty of stuff that can be done. Oh, sorry. Oh, darn it! I'm so terribly sorry! Didn't mean to do that. Sorry. I actually do have a second screen that displays that was being streamed, but the problem is that second screen is not particularly big, and I need to have the chat there as well so I can read it, and I... sorry, I'm trying to just deal with this stuff. Doesn't matter. Sorry about that. I did it again. This always happens at least once in a tournament. So anyway, for a recap, Klon started out with the Cloaky Bot Factory in the south side of the map, rather unusual, built up some glaives, didn't really do any damage, and now Lauri has the majority of the map, has a massive economic advantage, 1.5 times the economy of Klon. Klon trying to take the eastern side of the map and doing a pretty decent job, and now the glaives don't want to die. Yeah, terribly sorry about that. I really meant to show it. I'm I don't know why I didn't. This was a bit odd. Yeah, that... Sorry about that. Yeah, it's another radio cast. That happens. Anyway, back to the game. So we have now at this point a glaze for Klon and a couple warrior... Well, a warrior. While mace... One mace is up, another mace is just about finished, and the first mace about to meet up with the glaives, and that will kill them. Very quickly. The warrior will help, but really... The counter to this is Rocco's. The counter is always Rocco's when it comes to skirmishers. I mean, when it comes to riots. Skirmishers beat riots. Riots beat raiders. Raiders beat skirmishers, which aren't in play right now because Klon didn't decide to build any. Not sure why, but they haven't. So that mace is... You know, like, I don't know how it's going to work for these glaives, but they are going to get some shots in. A couple of them are going to die, but there are enough glaives. They overwhelm that mace, and that dies in Klon's territory. So Klon, use these conjurers. Reclaim. That's your only hope. Actually, got stuck on the ridge too, so that's one more dagger that's out. And of course, the glaives do have auto repair outside of combat, which is very nice. And now Klon's actually managing to make this payoff, which is really weird because this is an early game strategy, not a late game strategy. Lauri is setting up the caretakers they need to build up faster. Klon has not done so. Klon does not have any caretakers or workers or anything here to build up their factory, to build up their units quickly. They are building up a caretaker over to the north. I'm expecting an air switch or a vehicle switch over to the north. And it's probably going to become a more typical Red Comet game if it's a vehicle switch. If it's an air switch, then it will still be a little bit wonky, but a vehicle switch is basically going to be going to a typical Red Comet game 5 minutes after it would start, normally. But yeah, there's the caretaker there. There's a factory switch that's likely. And the glaives going in, committing suicide en masse. Not the most effective strategy. They do not explode. They are not roaches. They apparently thought they were roaches, and they are not. Worth noting for future, but Klon is going for an air switch, so this game will continue to be a little bit odd. I mean, air switch is a typical switch for the second factory, but still. This has been an odd game so far. And caretaker being built up over here as well by the Cloakybot factory, I just don't know. I'm not sure I really agree with that. Given that they are trying to focus on air, and they only have 24 metal income. Whereas Lauri has far more of the map, has most of the south side, has 31 metal income. Klon getting a bit more metal here and there, but yeah, as Klon even pointed out in the chat, they don't have their expansion properly. They just don't. It's not there. Which is a bit of a problem, because they kind of need that metal. And that's why I'm saying, why are they doing... Is the Cloakybot factory on low priority? No, it's on mid priority, as is... Yeah, both factories on mid priority. The priorities are going to be a bit problematic here. However, there are enough defenses, at least the daggers are out of the way, but the Klon's going to lose their commander. The maces will kill the commander. It's not an if, it's now. Down goes Klon's commander, up comes a raven, that's just one raven, we'll be able to take out one of these maces, and goes exactly for the wrong, oh actually, okay, goes to the right for the wrong one, but that hits the right one, so it works out okay, ultimately, and does defend. Once again, all this metal inside Klon's territory, they can reclaim. If they reclaim, they will be fine. But they need to reclaim. Need to get the reclaim going, and now I can kind of see why. Oh, even then, the caretaker is a little bit iffy of his choice, but it kind of works. Anyway, Klon over to the south does have the warriors, and we do see there is the raven coming in. But yeah, at this point, Klon 17 metal to 40 metal. Lauri is so far ahead. I am not surprised at this, but yeah, this is kind of done. And yeah, Skazi pointing out, yeah, bombing the higher HP one. Because they were close together, it worked out really well. If they weren't, that would have been two maces instead of one. And at that point, normally I would say, yes, that would be overkill. But given how close it was to destroying everything in the base, reducing the damage was much more important than avoiding overkill. However, the way it went down was perfect. That was the ideal way it could have gone down. And Klon going for some counter raiding, trying to at least stop Lauder from getting this mad expansion. This is where the ravens would be really useful. They should just be bombing out... I mean, bombing out defenders is not a bad idea. Bombing out metal extractors, however, that's where it's going to be very valuable. And glaives and warriors trying to get around, trying to find just that weak spot they can come into. And glaives... Comes a couple of glaives coming in, taking out these defenders, so at least any future ravens can go through the north side. While Klon expands to the north as well. South side... Getting attacked! Lauri going for the south side, wants to get rid of these warriors, does have the scalpels to do it with. Taken out, actually, overkilling the warriors, but those scalpels not being assaulted. No glaives to come in to deal with that once the scalpels have been put on reload time. See, really not much can be said in favor of Klon here. They're really not doing well. They're catching up. They're getting some reclaim here and there. But yeah, these ravens, they need to work miracles. Every one of them needs to work miracles. They need to be probably killing the commander next. If they can kill the commander, at least that's less build power at the front lines. But right now, there's so many defenders around that commander, it's going to be impossible. At least with three. Maybe with four or five, but not with three. Three would just be suicide. Anyway, it's going to be a little bit tricky, but I think Klona has the three ravens, so that's something. But Swifts have come up from Lauri. Lauri gone for an air switch as well, gone for Swifts, going to defend against their commander. Sorry, defend their commander pretty well. Commander will not die. There's too much defense. There's just too much air defense. I really don't know anything Klona could do right now. Like I said, that Cloaky Factory was an early game strategy, especially in the corner like it was. Glaives coming for one last raid attempt, but they need to spread out. These scalpels coming in, and Clone's not aware of this, not yet, but yeah, if they can get the glaives away, because the splash will do tons of damage. But yeah, these glaives just go in a nice line and then attack the scalpels. They're not going to die as much. They're going to die, just not as much. And down go... Well, actually, the ravens... No, the ravens were smart. They went off to the side. They're off into the corner, so they're still alive. But yeah, at this point, Klon trying to go for the kill. And, sorry, Lauri going for the kill. Klon has to defend against this, but it's not going to have much luck, really. The Glaives come in as one last-ditch effort, but right now, Lauri can just rebuild everything they have in the span of about a minute. Klon basically can't. Yeah, like, double income, it's... The army is twice the size. Sharpshooter coming in here to try to even things out for anti-heavy, but even then, it's not great. It'll lose some damage, it'll get rid of a scalpel or two, but that's about it. And at this point, Lauri is just moving for the kill so much, actually not even getting rid of scalpel or two. The glaives are going to help, but there's just not enough glaives to take all the missiles and then kill the scalpels afterwards when the scalpels are on reload. Getting a few of them, which is nice, but they're going to get another shot off, and that shot's going to stop all the glaives from getting in. And it looks like, yeah, that's what's going to happen. That's it. That's rather unfortunate. I also need to double check the camera, because that weird prediction thing never happened before. Anyway, Klon is... Yeah, look at what Lauri... Like, Lauri has all this, has two-thirds of the map easily. Twice the metal... Actually, Klon's getting some good reclaim, but that's only going to last a short while. We are getting into the phase where reclaim matters more, but Lauri has more territory they can easily reclaim in. And they are moving to reclaim this area as well. This is their territory. They have this. This is still kind of contested, but Klon basically cannot hold it if pushed. If Lauri pushes for it, they're going to take it. Now, Klon is trying to go for a few hawks, trying to use those. I don't know. Even then, that's not great. And sharpshooters shooting at radar dots and not doing much. Unfortunately, due to the radar drift, they were not able to hit. Yeah, sharpshooters pretty much need to have proper line of sight. Getting rid of a couple of... Nah, the solar plants, not going to do much. That is not going to do much at all, unfortunately. So Lauri just needs to find the right position to push in on. Because Klon is keeping themselves alive pretty long. They're actually... They're surviving better than I would have expected, but they're just holding on. The sharpshooter is doing a wonderful job pushing back, trying to get rid of these solar collectors. At least that's a wall that's gone. Getting rid of the lotuses and defenders. That's what they really need to do. They get rid of those, then at least that way it's easier for other units to come in. And Scythe as well, like, Klon's going for a bunch of the sneaky stuff. And Lauri doesn't really seem to care. Lauri really couldn't be less concerned. I mean, they're not really focusing on the south side of the map. They're losing a few buildings here and there, but... I mean, look at Lauri's army. In fact, I have to shrink this in order to actually show the size of Lauri's army right now. Because Lauri's army is very big. 11,000 metal compared to 3.9. And total air control. 12 Swifts compared to, what, 3 Hawks? Yeah, and now Lowry's going for the north side kill. I mean, valiant effort, but now with units coming, units just streaming in, this Scythe is going to get spotted out. Klon is not paying attention. Halberd about to get it. Spots it out. That Scythe is going to go down. Scalpel missiles take it out. Actually, no, not quite. The Scythe barely survives. Sharpshooter going to try to get a few more shots in. But the mace over to the north takes out everything. Lowry takes out the entire north side. The factory here is done. All the units in it are done. The south side's a bit easier to defend, but even then, like I said, just this is why people rarely start on the southeast side of the map. It kind of makes sense as a tricky strategy if you're going to go for something quick. if you're going to go for something where basically you're attacking within the first 2 or 3 minutes with a pretty large force of glaives or something like that, that would work nicely. But the problem is that didn't happen. Klon is trying to play for the late game despite the fact that they went for an early game focused strategy. Which is rather unfortunate for them because it does mean that they are 1 point down. They gave Lauri that point. So Lauri wins this one as well. So far, Lauri has been undefeated. It's 2-0. And Klon is 1-1. Curious though, where is... Oh yeah, the Klon is thinking it would work against vehicles, not against hovers, unfortunately. So from here, I think Old Ghost Doctor, I think everyone else is still playing, yeah. Old Ghost Doctor and Felix are playing, Vermine and Kane are playing, so we don't have any matches going on until those are done. And those have been going for about the same amount of time. So that is probably going to be a time for a short break. We'll see though. Waited a couple minutes, we can talk about what happened in that game. So, yeah, that was like Cloaky on Hovercraft, really tough thing to do. Against light vehicles, I don't think it would have worked very well. Against heavy tanks, I could see that working okay. I mean, it's still a bit tricky because Kodachi just counter glaives, but at least it would have been something. The problem is that when you're dealing with heavy tanks, or sorry, with Hovercraft, you're dealing with units that aren't that much more expensive than your own, and that ball up a lot better than yours do. Like, daggers just ball up like mad. And then, of course, maces exist. So yeah, if those glaives had come in and done a lot of raiding damage early on, that would have probably helped a fair bit. And then from there, build... I don't know, like, you can't really play for the late game with that, that's the problem. And Red Comet's a mid to late game map, like, it's... You're trying to win in the 10-15 minute range, not in the 5 minute range. So I can sort of see why that was done. It was tricky, it was different. I like seeing things that are different. Kinda wish it would have worked, but it didn't. Anyway, just me waiting until the next match, which I don't know who's going to be. Okay, score one for Kane. So Kane has one against Vermind, and we're just waiting for Old Ghost Darker and Ophelius to report. Here's who they played on. It looks like, judging by the game, they played on Alien Desert. As are Ophelius and Old Ghost Darker. Red Comet was only played on Klon and Lauri. So we're moving on, and then after this, we might have tiebreakers depending. If Lauri just wins the next one, then it's going to be Lauri wins. If we have ties, then we probably will have a tiebreaker match just to sort that out. And if not, then that will be it. Because yeah, the tiebreak score here, that only really works when you've played, well, the Buchholz tiebreak. Buchholz? Buchholz? Not sure how it's pronounced. Anyway, yeah, it's... Best and worst scores discarded, so in the last match we'll get this tiebreak score, or we'll have a regular tiebreak score. Depending on how that works out, but it looks like it is going to probably come down to the wire. But yeah, if Lauri wins the next one, that's going to be game, or that's going to be tournament. Not sure if I'm going to want to watch that one though. I mean, I might do that one as a second one. Like, I might do, because looks of it, whoever loses here, like... Vermind or possibly Old Ghost. I think Vermind is going to be fighting against Aufgebot. So Vermind and Aufgebot are going to be fighting. Or Vermind's going to get the buy, and Aufgebot and Kane are going to be fighting. And then that leaves Orphelius and Lauri to probably, well, depending on who wins between Old Ghost Darker and Orphelius. The winner of that will be against Lauri, and Klon will fight the loser of that, I think. I'm kind of guessing, but I'm fairly certain that's what'll happen. Because yeah, actually, if either of these players win, then it will be a tiebreaker between Lauri and them. So I'll do that second, actually. That's what I'll do. Anyway. So we will have that once Orphelius and Old Ghost Stalker are done. And I don't know when that'll be. Probably in the next couple minutes, though. Anyway, stay tuned for that. I'll be back in just a moment and enjoy the intermission music in the meantime.